fixed the sound on the truck so it wasn't so loud. Got that brake going. I also fixed my multi-fruit standard script, I guess it's called. So Milo wasn't even in there. That's why I wasn't able to play. Park right there for now. So that guy's going. Got our monstrous. end with my new favorite tractor that pretty excited to like start working on updating the big cat Challenger. Kind of turned my attention to getting my CT660 finished. up its LUA file for something as simple as a, like an attachable thing, like a bucket might be. But I think that'd be something to look into for, like a rotator, make a drive box, and then a sprayer. I'm assuming it's like an attachable thing, like a bucket where you attach and detach it. Bigger ATI of the new crop, because it's hours on it. trade that in for another big bin. Maybe like a 1090. Maybe another 990. Who knows? Lexion 770. It's an option. At least we'll head to the castle.
Thank you.
went through seed like nobody's business. Pretty decent view. Not a whole lot going on today. 44s. Field 3 needs to be done. 27, 28, 26, 25. 2, 1, 13, 14, 24, 23. So quite a bit left the plant. But we've done 19, 37, 11, north and south, 12, 15, 10, east and west. 17, 29, 34, and now 18. So, and then obviously 20 planting with alfalfa last week. So, we're making progress. We're getting there. Hopefully, we can hammer this stuff out in the next day, day and a half. Time is it now? So, they'll probably burn up another 6 hours. Four to six hours planting. Pretty much left today. Then we have all tomorrow and game time. You know, all Friday. Today is Thursday, so we have all Friday to finish up and return our planters because we leased them for 2 days. So, hopefully, we can plant our 1,200 acres in 2 days. That's the goal. I definitely think we'll be able to do it, but it's definitely gonna take probably another 10 hours, I would guess, to finish up planting. Because that field 2, that's probably gonna be about an hour and a half, 2 hours. That's about an hour and a half, 2 hours, so that's probably 3 to 4 hours. So, yeah, I would say probably 10. Hours of planting left to go, even with their DV 60s. Gotta love what, you know, I do love the improvements that they make over 13. They actually incorporate a lot of scripts that you had to script into a mod itself. It's just part of the game now. I'm glad. Giants kind of put a survey together a while back asking, like, okay, like, we know we have, like, these 12 things we really need to improve upon, but we're probably only going to focus on, like, the top 3 or top 4 things, depending on, you know, if it's 3 big things or, you know, 2 big, 1, you know, whatever it is, but, definitely I think they need to incorporate, you know, soil management. I think soil management, Decker and them guys, you know, I think they have the ability to do soil management better than Giants themselves can do. Just being honest, I think Giants has other priorities, such as fixing the in-game economy. That's something Giants can do, and that's something that you can do with more realistic. But I think the ability of having, you know, if they were to really beef up the economy in this game, the ability to do contract pricing or, like, missions, how they have missions set up, you can do, you can contract grain at this rate, or a grain demand actually lasts, like, the whole duration without the price going down. I don't know, I think that would be something that is so intuitive that I don't even know why it is the way it is. I mean, you have a great demand for 10 hours or 12 hours. You sell all your grain in 1 hour, the price is completely... It's a great demand, for Christ's sakes. You know, it doesn't make sense. So, little things like that that they need to improve upon. And I'd honestly really like to see multiple... The ability to have multiple navigation missions for animals. You know, I want to have multiple pastures. I want to have... multiple farms that I can buy with my viable objects, and the cows will spawn, but a cow will only spawn at this farm if, you know, it's like farm one, farm, you know, multiple, the ability to have multiple farms, I'm saying, but even that's not even, but definitely having the ability to have multiple separated navigation meshes without the cows getting, like, or chicken, or sheep, or whatever it is, getting snagged on the edge of it if you separate the navigation meshes. Obviously improve your physics, improve threshing area and capacity. I want there to be a difference in combines when I buy them. I mean, you can slap a big ass 45 foot draper header on the smallest combine in game, and you'll be able to harvest at the same speed, you'll get the same yield. It's just a little bit underpowered. That's the only thing that's different, and then the grain capacity. So there's really no difference between combines. there wasn't in 13. So hopefully that's one thing that they improve upon, is the ability of to differentiate between threshing and cleaning areas. In that if you were to put a bigger header on a smaller combine, you would have to go really slow, but it would automatically like slow down, or you get a yield loss. So, I mean, these are things that I don't think would require much of an investment in time or money to actually do. They're little things that, you know, just need to actually be done. Because it's, honestly, if you're calling this game Farming Simulator, it's, I'd kind of be embarrassed at that point. But I mean, a lot of things have, you know, viable objects that you can script that in easy. Now they have the bank mod. The bank mod is really great. However, it has little issues if your lease goes up or you sell a field. It has a really weird terrain glitch. It deletes everything within the field dimensions. So it's kind of a weird glitch. I don't really understand it, but that's one thing. Improvements over 13. Definitely the particle systems greatly improved. The lighting greatly improved, the tracks greatly improved, the crop textures and animations greatly improved. The fact that they went to a more realistic weight system from drills, where it's actually based on the actual listed kilogram, it's reflected in the i3D, so it's a lot easier to kind of calculate your mass, and then the ability to find your center of gravity and stuff like that. It really takes all the guesswork out of it. The power, it's kind of weird. I still don't really fully understand the torque and differentials, how they have their initial compressions and stuff like that. It's still pretty complicated, and I don't really have a firm grasp on it yet, but it definitely gives a lot more options available. I really like the fact that now you can have multiple XML scripts in only one object. So like my cat Challenger, I have a yellow, black, and pink model, but there's only one shape, and like you can turn on and off, like true and false objects in the i3D. You can make them invisible or visible based on the XML. So that's really cool. I did the same thing on the Wilsons with white and black. There's two XMLs per trailer, per i3D. So that's great. It allows you the ability to really reduce your size of your files and the amount of... you still kind of have to have your textures, so you don't really save space on your textures, but you do save space on the extra models. So let's say you have three colored vehicles, you only need one shape, so you save the memory of the two other i3D files, which can be significant. Unless you do the color picker thing, which I feel like you don't have as much control over how nice. If you were to burn the texture as bright as possible white you can get, it may or may not look that great. I personally still like to burn the textures in a DDS file, because I tried that color switcher on my Kenworth, and it doesn't really look that great in other colors. White, it looks good in white. Looks good in yellow too. What else? Seems like there's a lot of brilliant guys working on scripts for different kind of tillage practices to incorporate with soil management, like compaction and different kind of appearances based on what kind of cultivator and plowing you're doing. So that's really cool. The whole drive control mod by Upside Down, brilliant. The multi-fruit, additional fruit types, that was brilliant as well. That really took all the work out of scripting every single vehicle from field planes and stuff like that. And the fact that now that the map has the placeholders for all the particle animations and field planes, so you only have to put it in once, and it's on the job of the map maker to do all that, and you don't really need any to do any work to like trailers or stuff. stuff like that to accept fruits and have a particle animation for everything. It's all part of the map and core game itself now. So it took a lot of the tedious work from the modding standpoint and kind of made it standard. Like, it's part of the game now. So that's really good. I appreciate it. It really reduces a lot of time when it comes to modding and updating and changing and stuff like that. And all to reduce memory, basically. Reduce the amount of RAM, the amount of memory you're using on your GPU, amount of memory you're using on your hard drive, amount of caching everything has to do. So it's trying to make everything as the least amount of redundancy as possible. So on that respect, they're getting pretty clever with that, and it's really convenient, and everyone wins in that situation. Spec maps, I think I kind of have it understood. The only thing is I don't really manually UV any of my mods. I just do a smart UV project. So they don't look very pretty. But there's ways around that. You can texture your model in, I use Blender, so you can kind of like paint your dirt on your model and then like burn that as a file and save that as a dirt skin, which you can incorporate into your spec map blue layer. I haven't tried that, but it's something I really want to do because I'm getting kind of sick of all my kind of lack of control on my spec maps. So I'm probably going to figure out how to do that, because basically the weakest point of a lot of my nice mods now is the actual spec map. It doesn't really do a lot of the hardware justice, so that's something I'm going to try to learn and figure out. And once I figure that out, hopefully I can share with you guys. I'm still waiting my new the new channel I'm trying to get up and running, the building in Blender. I haven't looked, but I imagine it's probably around 350, 400 subscribers. I'm requesting minimum of 1,000 before I start doing in-depth cookbook Blender building and Blender tutorials. Not that I'm an expert, but I know enough to pretty much do whatever I want, and it turns out pretty well. But like things like manual UV mapping, I have literally no idea how to do that proficiently. But I will learn, and how to use texture paint to paint over your already baked textures. That's another thing that I kind of have a good idea how it works, but I have yet to do it to incorporate it in that into this program. But that would be like later on videos, more advanced stuff, obviously, because if I don't know how to do it yet, it's probably not that easy. Or maybe it is, I don't know, I never really took the time to really dive into it. Another thing is, the farm silos that recently discovered in like the past couple weeks, finally got those babies dialed in, and actually we'll just put some over there. This is a great script, and it takes your silos. It's kind of like a condensed version of Universal Process Kit. It's a self-contained dump trigger and unload and load trigger, and it has displays if that's something you're into, but it gives you the ability to put a capacity on the dump trigger, not the silos necessarily themselves. But if I'm going to dump here at this dump site, it's only going to hold 20,000 bushels total on this whole complex. Not like it's like that side. It's not that advanced. But you can see here that I have my huts now. Corn got 1.6 million. Yeah. That's one thing, getting an auger like that, as a vehicle. But how to make it work without moving your unload triggers is one thing. So I guess you could put like triggers on top of all your silos and move it over it or something, or you could just kind of. I don't know how you would script that, to be honest. Anyways, calling it a day, so thanks for watching.